This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, guys, let's do it now. We have done till this yesterday, and some of numbers, that's what we have done. Another program, write a program to find a factorial of a given number. Suppose if I give 5, I should get 5 factorial, that is some 120, something like that. If I give 6, I should get 720. If I give 8, I should get something like that. You keep doing it. Come on. You can take input from N from keyboard and you can try that. If you have any questions, I can answer on that. And your sessions will be more of hands-on training only. I don't talk too much theory in most of the sessions. So this is an area where you have to master yourself. If you want to have a better future in programming and coding. Okay, do it and then submit your answers, and then I'll see if any corrections are required, then we'll take it. Then we'll take another program. Like this, we have so many programs. Until some level, I'll keep discussing with you. I'll make you to work. Later on, once a level is reached, we'll have more assignments. We'll plan like how to solve them. We'll give you a task and we'll work on that.
Excuse me. Ask it now. Sarah, what's a factorial?
Factorial is nothing but, you know, suppose if we have 5 factorial, okay, means it's something like this. It's like 5 into 4 into 3 into, okay, 3 into 1. That's the idea about 5 factorial. Means starting with that number to the, you know, to that, till that we have to come to this point. This is called 5 factorial. Product of all the sequence starting from that to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 into, till that it becomes up to 1. That's 5 factorial. That's factorial actually. Got it right?
Yeah, thank you.
Like this you have to do. Suppose if it is 6 factorial, same, the logic comes like n into n minus 1 into something like that. But you have to do it in a programmatic way. That's the point.
Sir, I just sent my clone.
Yeah, it's good, Lasya. I see that you are really making it good. I appreciate. I hope you can do more exercises. Give me some time. Meanwhile, try this program, Lasya. I don't want you to waste your time. Let me improve your strength of logical implementation. Others, you can do this.
Okay, sir.
You continue with this. I'll give some work for Lasya so that she get engaged. Write a program to find the product of all even numbers from 1 to 10. Or 1 to n, it's up to you. If you take 1 to 10 or n, it's up to you. Come on. Those who finish it fast, then I'll give one more small program. Until others finish it, you can keep engaged. So your time is not wasted. No issues, it's not for you. You can take your time, Snigdha. You don't have any rush here. Only if somebody finishes, I give some other program. Maybe you can work it later also, not today.
Yeah, I just accidentally entered it when I wasn't done.
No problem, Siddha. No problem. Take your time. You are not in any hurry. No hurry. Be cool. Do take your own time. Finish it and submit. There is no hurry on your side. I am not after you. What is my thing is I want you to think, understand and apply. That is important. So what is it, Sandhya? You gave me something, a shocking program. Okay. Enter an integer, that's good. You converted it, that's fine. Then you try to add. Something is missing here, Sandy. Okay. I see that you are out of the track. Okay, Sandy. You completely moved out of the track. Okay, you have to use some looping and then you need to give me the factorial program. That's how you have to work here. Okay, but I didn't see anything towards that, going towards factorial, Sandy. So check your program and correct it.
I forgot to add my the while statement.
While is there, and I ask you to do factorial, which is a product. But still you are doing addition. I don't think it's a recommended one. So you think on that lines, Mr. Sandy. Okay, Lasya is again now. See, keep doing. You don't need to. What is that? Hurry anyway. Take your time. Solve it. Still, if you need any help, you ask me. Don't hesitate. Programming is not a race. Running race here. You know, with the time and practice, everybody will be on the same page. I know that. I can tell you one thing. When I was in college. Many of my classmates used to do coding far, far better than me. They are very fast and they used to do solve many things like that. And I used to look at them, I used to wonder how these guys are doing those problems. But now if I look back and if I check with them, I can definitely say that I am far ahead of them. I can do better programming than those guys who are very fast in my sessions. Got it right? So it's a matter of practice and perseverance. You got it right. I'm waiting for a few more people's answers, like Sigda and Pranav. I think even I'm waiting for Pranav. Sandy need to correct his program. Sandy, a couple of things were missing from your program. Okay. If you need help, still we can discuss after class, Sandy. I'll wait for you. Not just for Sandy, for anyone. If you want to discuss more, you need a little bit of explanation, more than what we discuss. Still, you can take it after the session. It's applicable for everyone. Anybody can wait after class. You want to ask me more deeper explanation also. But it don't hesitate. Don't feel shy. Yeah, Pranav is good. It's good, Pranav. Yeah. I know him. I can understand Pranav. Don't worry. I'm doing it from past 14 years. Probably I can get that understanding. No need to worry on that. But it's good. You have done an excellent job. Snigdha is excellent and Lasya is super. Shreya is also submitted, right? Snigdha, sorry. Shreya submitted. Snigdha is still doing. Yeah, Sandy have modified his code this time. Sandy, this time you are good. Okay.
Yes, sir.
That's excellent, Sandy. This is what I am expecting from you, Sandy. Good job.
Thank you, sir.
Shraddha, do you finish it?
I'm almost done.
Yeah, fine, fine, no issues. Please submit it, then we'll move to the next topic. Once you're done, not. Okay. Yeah, Snigdha, I think it's good. Let's move to the next program. Once you are done factorial, then the next program is write a program to find factors of a given number. Suppose now you know how to find sum, all that factorial, all that. Now the next thing is finding factors. I have a number like this, some 6. You know, right? All of you know the factors thing, right? Hope you are at that level, just having some idea about factors. Yes, sir. Tell me, guys. Yes, sir. See, you have to talk, guys. If that is the case, there is no point of me taking a session.
Yes, sir.
ఇప్పుడు మాట్లాడకపోతే నేను ఒక సెషన్ చేయడం వల్ల మనకి ఏం రాదండి. నేను అడుగుతున్న క్వశ్చన్ ఏంటంటే 6 ఫ్యాక్టర్స్ ఏంటి? నువ్వు ఒకటే కదా సార్ అండి. వాట్ అబౌట్ అదర్స్? లాస్య, ప్రణవ్ అండ్ శ్రేయ అండ్ స్నిగ్ధ. వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ టు యు గైస్?
1, 2, 3, 6.
ఓకే, యూ కీప్ క్వైట్ మ్యాన్.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's not like when I insist, then you should not talk. When I ask you a question, try to answer it. Otherwise, no, it's really tough for me, okay? So when six is there, just at least tell me that whether you know that or not, so that I can explain it. But if nobody talks, then it's like talking to me, right? So what are the factors of six? Any idea?
1, 2, 3, 6.
1, 2, 3, and a 6. Will others agree with this? Does others have an idea on this? Like Shreya and Sinda or Pranav or Sandy?
Yes, sir.
That's good. Suppose if 6 is this and it has these factors. Now this is what I am expecting from you. And how do you do that? The logic is simple. You take a number, that n. So usually when you are, you know, giving me the factors, when you tell me the factors, in your mind you do this. What do you do that? You try to, from 1 to 6. Okay. You might be thinking whether 6 is divisible by 1. This is the thought process happening in the mind, and it is equal to 0. And whether 6 is divisible by 2, or whether 6 is divisible by 3, or whether 6 is divisible by 4, this happens till up to 6. And you don't try to again divide after 6 or before 6, I mean before 1. But 1 to that number n, whatever it is, you try to check every time this 1, 2, 3 or 4, all these are divisors of the 6 or not. Okay, that is what you do generally. And if it is dividing, then it's a factor. Otherwise, it's not a factor. We learned it somewhere in school days. Now you have to do this in a program. You need a loop and a condition check. You need to solve this. So, okay. I think I have explained everything that is necessary to implement this logic. You have to just, you know, create some syntax, and you need to see how you can write a code for that. The logic part is clearly explained to everyone. Anybody has questions, you can ask me. Anybody has questions, guys?
No, sir.
No questions, sir.
What about others?
Questions, sir.
At least from one of you, from Shreya or Sigda, at least one of you try to give answer me, okay? I think both of you are at same place or different places. I don't know.
Okay.
At least one of you, okay? Because you have to interact. You have to talk, guys. That is important. Okay. So are you guys good now? Is this logic clear for all of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir.
So do this program then. Do it. So solve this and submit me the answer. If required, I'll show you how to do it. I think I need to solve even factorial. I will also show a program from my side as well. The factorial and this both will solve at a time.
Oh, hello, sir.
Was it?
Oh, I was just wondering if you're still there because it was so silent.
I will be there because until the session is done, I have to be there.
Okay, because sir.
I'm seeing the, you know, because now Pranav done, Shreya done, Lasya done, still Snigdha is doing, if I'm not wrong. I'm still standing here to submit the answer. Okay. So once they are done, then definitely we can move forward. Okay. Lasya. If I'm not talking means I'm waiting for the answers, that's all. And you can also see in the chat box. Chat box is visible for everyone, if I'm not wrong, okay?
Yes, sir, I can see.
Means I'm waiting for some answers, that's all. Sandy, you have enough time?
Oh, I'm still working on the program, sir.
Yeah. You do one thing.
I'm almost done though.
Yeah, I'll tell you how to do that. First observe. Later on, you can finish it quickly. Because we have enough time there. What do you say?
Okay, sir. Just give me one more minute and I'll be done.
Okay, fine. Give me one or two sessions time for others. I promise you don't wait. You don't need to wait if you have finished your tasks. Because there will be so many tasks, and you can take one some other task. Because I may not directly discuss, you know, every task in the class. You can pick up one and you can keep solving meanwhile. Like that, you can utilize your 100% time there in the session. Okay, just only for one or two sessions. Still will be looking after everything. Okay. At the previous program, which is the simpler one, finding factors. It's simple. You just take something like some I equal to 1. Suppose I just want input from keyboard. I say int of, you know, you can do it directly in one statement. You can say something like enter n, okay. Then while that's my you know, number to find factorial, and I less than or equal to n, and then colon, then print of, sorry, it should have the logic, you know, something like f equal to 1. Declare a variable to initialize the result, set to 1, don't set it to 0. When you are performing, set your resultant variable to 0. If you are performing product, set your resultant variable to 1. You know the maths basic here. Okay. You know, why should we initialize to 1 or 0? In product, if we initialize to 1, then adding or multiplying something with 1 doesn't change the result. But with 0 will definitely make an impact, will modify the result. So when you are doing product, try to, you know, initialize 1 while doing some, try to initialize to 0. So then f equal to f into I, that's all. And you just need to increment I. You can do it like in any way, I equal to I plus 1. You can do a decrementation from some n to 1, n might be 5 to 1 or 1 to 5. In whichever the order you do the product, there won't be change in the result. So that's why I just choose to do it in this way. But you can do it the other way. That's up to you. Okay. And print f here. That gives the product. Again, I'm giving 5. I got 120 perfect. I don't need to wait for another one. So the other one is finding factors. You can take n, still can be there. Then for factor, I don't need this f now. I'm removing it. You can iterate from 1 to n. That's fine. This is perfect. And you need a condition to see that your input are the variable, sorry, are the value for which you are finding the factors, or the number which you are for which you are finding the factors. What you have to do is you have to apply condition check from 1 to every time you should see that that number divides this n or not. Okay, so this is what you have to do. And then a print of I here. If I is dividing n, I is a factor. Okay, else I is not a factor. That's what you should do. And nothing else is required. Just increment I after that. Okay, equal to I plus 1. So Sandy, you can see this. You know what I told you yesterday after class. While I am explaining, first try to listen. Later on, you can you know keep working on your task. But what I suggest is, I request you first to concentrate for what with on what I am explaining. Okay, then you can take your task and you can go with that task. Got it right? But don't keep engaged yourself in that that thing. That's what I suggest. Increment it, and definitely this is a simple program to find factors of a given number. I give 6. It's not just 6. You can give any number of something which you like. Okay, again run that. Okay, and then you give 10. You might have some other factors, but definitely they are factors. Definitely they divide this number, no doubt about it. Okay, you have a couple of tasks now, so we can keep doing it. Next program. Sandy, did you finish it? You got it, like how to do that? Okay. But the print is misplaced, Mr. Sandy, and the increment is misplaced. Okay. So I'm sure that this won't work. The code print has to be inside if block. And that incrementation has to be inside while, not in if, outside while, inside if. The indentation is missing here. Of course, it might change a bit here, but there's a correction necessary. That's why I suggested to listen and focus on what I'm explaining when I am explaining. Okay, so you don't make these mistakes again and again. Got it right? Now another program. This is the program. I have explained clearly what to do on this. Still, if you have issues, you can wait after class. We might discuss one more time. Write a program to find a sum of factors of a given number. And then another program. Write a program to find sum of even factors of a given number. Another program. Write a program to find count of factors of a given number. Every program is different from the other. Don't get confused. If you have any questions, ask me. Don't keep quiet. Find count of factors of a given number. Sum means, suppose if 6 is there, okay, I'm just giving you the input. What should be the input and what should be the output? Output has to have these 3 factors, 1, 2, 3. 6. So it should be 12 here. Output should be 12. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. And then the other one is sum of even factors. Even factors means I have 2 and 6 as, if it is 6, I should get out. The input is 6 again. You can take input as 6. And the output has to be, what is it? 2 plus 6, 8. Only sum of even factors. Third one, count of factors. Suppose if I give 6, if this is the input which I am giving, okay, the output has to be what should be the output? The output should be this. Output is, I should get 4 like this. So now this is more clear for everyone. Should be, I have clearly, you know, given everything here. So what is the tool? You can write the code according to that. Already you know how to find factors. You know how to find sum of numbers. Now you have to mix all that and do the code. You can see slowly we are increasing the depth of logic building. This goes little further. You can see little more complex programs, but we build it in a righteous way. Okay. Sani, do you understand the mistake or the correction that is needed to your code? Did you get it? Others, you keep solving them.
No, sir.
Okay. So that's what I told you, Sandy. I think I told you this number of times, and still, you know, you need to come to that level. What I told is, listen to me when I am explaining. Later on, you can work on your problem, but I see that's not happening. So what shall we do, Sandy? Tell me, you suggest me. There are two things. Either you have to listen to me, or either you have to do it. Got it, Sandy?
Yes, sir, continue.
So I told you yesterday and I told you today at the beginning of session. Then cheptunna Sandy. చెప్పేటప్పుడు వినాలి అనేది నేను ఇప్పటికి మీకు చాలాసార్లు చెప్తున్నాను. అయినా కూడా మీరు ఆ సిస్టమ్ మీద టిక్ 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 అని కొడుతూ ఉన్నారు. సో నేను సజెస్ట్ చేసేది ఏంటంటే, నేను చెప్పేటప్పుడు మీరు వింటే ఇంకొంచెం మీకు అర్థమవుతుంది ఎక్కడ మిస్ అవుతున్నారు అనేది. తర్వాత మీరు చేస్తే ఇంకా ఈజీ అవుతుంది. ఓకేనా సండి? సో అగైన్ ఐఎమ్ సజెస్టింగ్, ప్లీజ్ లిసన్ టు మీ, ఐఎమ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్. వన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ డన్, దెన్ యూ కెన్ డూ ది ప్రాక్టీస్. ఆర్ అదర్వైజ్ యూఆర్ కాన్ఫిడెంట్ టు సాల్వ్ ఇట్, డూ ఇట్. బట్ ఒక్కసారి నేను చెప్పేది వినండి, వింటే మీకు కష్టం ఈజీ అయిపోతుంది అనమాట. ఇట్స్ నో ప్రాబ్లమ్. యు ఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఎక్సలెంట్ జాబ్, బాగా చేస్తున్నావు. బికాస్ టు యువర్ ఏజ్ ఇట్స్ రియల్లీ యునో వండర్ఫుల్ ద కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ యూఆర్ డూయింగ్. బట్ యునో ఎ బిట్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఇస్ నెసెసరీ హియర్ వైల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్. ఓకే, సో నాట్ సేయింగ్ యూఆర్ What I am saying is you are not listening. There is a lot of difference in the statements. ఇక్కడ విను, ఇక్కడ ఇది తీసుకోవడం, ఈ n వర్క్ ఇన్పుట్ చేయడం తెలుసు నీకు. మనం ఏం చేయాలంటే, యాజ్ పర్ లాజిక్ 1 to n, యూ షుడ్ డివైడ్ ఎవరీ టైమ్ దట్ n, అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ డివైడ్స్ ఇట్స్ ఎ ఫ్యాక్టర్, దేర్ షుడ్ బి ఎ కండిషన్ చెక్ ఆఫ్ దట్ నంబర్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ వేర్ యూ ఆర్ మిస్సింగ్, యూ మిస్ ది ట్రాక్ హియర్. అండ్ ఐ కెప్ట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ దిస్ ఎర్లియర్, బట్ స్టిల్ యూఆర్ ఆన్ ది the keyboard. I am using that strokes, keystrokes. So what happens? This is the logic thing, Sandy. What is that? If my number is 6 from 1 to 6, I should check every time if 1 is divisible, dividing 6, 2 is dividing 6, 3 is dividing 6, or 6 is dividing 6. Here the point is, I should iterate a loop from 1 to 6 or 1 to n. If it is 10, I should iterate from 1 to 10. And every time I should see that I is divisible by dividing this n, or n is divisible by I. And if it is divisible, then I should print it. That's the logic thing. You got the point here, right, Sandy? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you can try this. You get some idea. Still, if you have doubts, you can ask me.
Sir, what's the last program we're supposed to do again?
Say program. Program to find factors of a given number. The logic is not correct there. One minute. Who is that?
Pranav? It's me, Pranav. Yeah.
Okay, Pranav. These are the problems you need to solve here.
Yeah, I did the first two. I just forgot the third one. So.
Okay, fine. No issues. I'm just scrolling it down.
Okay, thank you.
So who has completed all three problems? Last year and Pranav?
Yes, sir.
And Snigdha, I think, what about Snigdha? I can see some of factors. And then one more is Shreya has done one more. Even factors of a given number. Okay, that's perfect. Some more factors, okay. That has done. Snipta and Shreya, I think one program is. What about Sandy? I didn't see any programs from Sandy. Sandy, can you see, can you, are you doing them, Sandy?
Yes, sir.
What program you are doing?
I'm doing the even factors of the doing the even factors of the given number.
Okay. Can you did you finish it?
No, sir.
Okay. You do one thing, Sandy. You listen to me first and then you can try it afterwards, okay?
Yes, sir.
I'm doing them, I'm solving them. Because I see all others have already solved them. Okay. So first listen to these problems. And then after class, still if you don't have time now, you take time after class and complete all the tasks. Okay, take your own finish all the tasks, okay?
Yes, sir.
And that's, we'll plan in a different way. First one is finding sum of factors of a given number. So there is nothing much change required. Declare a variable sum s equal to sum. Then you can say you have to find this is for finding factors. And every time it's a factor, you need to find sum s equal to s plus I. That's enough. Outside the loop, not inside. You should increment I as well. But I is part of while, can you see? It's not inside if. You should take care of that. And then print up I here. Got it, right?
Yes, sir.
So, that's it. Sorry, I'm sorry. Print up S. Go to run and then run module. Enter in. Just for testing, I got 12 here, that's perfect. That is sum of factors. Another program, sum of even factors. Other problem is to find sum of even factors. Means have 1, 2, 3 and 6. I should find only sum of 2 and 6 because even factors. I should find only sum of even factors. And I have to add another quick condition. If I is a factor, then it comes inside. And again, I should check whether it is an even number or not. That is also important. Then here I should check for I percentile 2 equal to 0. Then I can find some of that. There are three filters. One filter for loop condition. Second filter for checking if number is a factor or not. I is a factor or not. Third filter, whether I is even or not. Finally, you should find some. And we should get here 8 here. That is second problem. Okay. I'm using 6 throughout the programs. I'm following 6 because already we have done analysis with 6. But it's not to stick for 6, but you can stick for anything else. It's up to you. But for some reason, what I'm getting 0. Mm-hmm. Getting 0. Let me rerun again. Sorry. me run again. Something is missing. Okay. Okay. Next one. That last one is a count of factors. If I give 6, I should get 4. It's 6 has 4 factors. Or if I give some 20, I should get 20 has how many factors? 1, 2, 3. I think 3 is a factor. 4, and then 5, and then 10. Some 3 or 4 factors are there. Sorry, 4 or 5 factors are there. We can check through code, not an issue. So, for no need of this, you can remove this even check, not necessary. But what is the point here? Count of factors. Then here I can use if not wrong. Instead of saying s equal to s plus I, I can say s plus 1. But better readability, I can take this as something like counter. The count set to 0. Initially, count of factors is 0. Every time I is increment that count by 1, count equal to count plus 1. Okay, and then just try to print the count here. Okay, that gives the count. Now I want to find count for 20. Let me see how many factors are there for 20. 6 factors are. Suppose if I want it for 6, 4 factors are there. This is how we find factors. All of you got it? I think all of you have solved it in your own way. No problem. But the point is, what is the point? Whether you are able to get the output in right way or not is important. How you write your logic is not a problem. You can do a problem in different ways. It's not like everybody should do in the same way. But at the end, two things matters. Is it taking proper inputs? Is it able to take the proper inputs? And is it giving the expected result? That is important. Okay. So next program. Okay. Write a program. Write a program. To find, to check whether a number is perfect or not. So that's it. So this is the problem. Okay.
Sir, what's a perfect number?
Yeah, I'm going to explain that. Okay. So suppose you take 6. How many factors were there? 1, 2, 3, 6. Find sum of all factors. How much you get? Sum of factors. How much you get?
12.
Perfect. You get 12. Okay. Right. This is actually the sum of all factors. Now you remove the sum of factor of itself, just exclude factor of itself and tell me the sum now. Find the sum of all factors excluding factor of itself.
6.
Okay, that's good. So now you see your actual number is 6. And then after that, sum of factors of n, okay, sum of factors of n, excluding factor of itself, is equal to, okay, n itself. Then such number is a perfect number, excluding factor of itself, is equal to n itself. Such number is what? A perfect number. You get this? Now you can see, you can take 6.
Yes, sir.
I told you to exclude 6, factor of 6, factor of itself, otherwise it's so easy. Then if you get the total sum as 6 itself, then it is a perfect number. Suppose you take, tell me any other random number, Shriya. I want Shriya to tell me one more number, random number. How much? Shreya.
Oh, 7.
Okay, 7, that's good. So 7 has how many factors? Shreya, I want you to be unmuted for some time. How many factors 7 has?
Seven is prime.
Okay, fine. Tell me, how many factors 7 has?
Well, 2 if you say 1 and 7.
Okay, 1 and 7. So fine. Tell me, sum of all the factors excluding factor itself, how much do you get, Shreya?
9.
I told you, right? Factor of itself, how much you get?
The sum of the factors of 7.
You understand this, right? Sum of factors of the 7 excluding factor of itself, how much you get?
1.
Perfect. So you tell me, is 7 equal to 1?
No.
Then it's not perfect. But okay. You see that here, 6 equal to 6 here. If you exclude and find the sum, you got 6 equal to 6. It's perfect. Got it, right? So, yeah. Okay, fine. Now you can do this problem. All of you can solve this right now. So what you have to do is almost the logic is same. You don't have a difference in the logic. Okay, you can do the same, almost similar logic. Small change is required. What is that? You try it yourself. If not, I will anyhow explain the problem. Okay, I will provide solution. You can cross check there. And also, once you don't have a big change in this code except a small correction in this code to fit that to find factors excluding factor of that, then you should have a condition check after the loop, not inside loop, whether the given number, this n, and this sum of factors, this is not sum, this is count, you need sum here. Okay, if sum of factors is same, you need an if else. You need to check, you need to apply a condition check after loop, so it will validate whether the given number and the sum is same or not. For that you need to apply a if else here. Okay, you try that, and if you have questions you can ask me. Okay, so that's the logic for this program. So understand this problem first.
Yes, sir, I understand.
No, I'm asking Sandy. Sandy?
Yes, sir.
Did you listen to what I have explained here about perfect number?
Yeah, I understood what a perfect number is, yes, sir.
What is perfect number, Sandy? Tell me.
A perfect number is the sum of all its factors except for itself.
Okay.
And the sum of all the factors has to equal itself to be a perfect number.
Perfect. Okay. So, can you do a program for this now?
Okay, sir.
Okay, do it. Right. Sandy, what is the stage of your program? Sandy, I'm asking you.
Oh, sir, I'm almost done. I've hit the next, my last is if statement, and then I have to print. Let's print the none.
Okay, do it and show it to me. Then I'll also give you the solution so that we can start the session here. Tomorrow, going to the another way of doing logics, then I will do this and we will be solving some. From there you can get some assignments. I told you, right? We might be focusing on the whole logic building programs. Later on you have to solve, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, did you finish your program?
Yeah, I finished it, but I'm testing it now.
Okay, Shreya is done. Pranav done. And then Lasya is done. And Snigdha, I think just now she posted.
I'm done, sir, but I'm debugging my code.
Okay, first, it's fine. Do you have any errors or what?
No, it's not showing me an error. When I want to. It's not giving me the sum, but when I like, can I share my screen?
You can paste your copy and paste the code. I will show you here. I will correct it here in my machine. Whatever you have read, just copy it and paste it. So this is your Sandy. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So this is to find whether your number is perfect or not. So y is loop variable and z is the n. You are trying to divide y with z, that's perfect. And then you say num equal to num plus y. Okay. Instead of num, put it as sum. That will be more better to understand the code, okay?
Yes, sir.
Give some meaningful variables. Okay, I appreciate for that. But this is fine. Almost you are good. But this if else, this condition check, you should not put inside this. Start put while. Let's while take care of, you know, finding some. Okay. Has to be outside loop, Sandy. Not inside.
That you. So why does it have to be outside the loop?
Because once you find completely, then you have to check the whether the actual number is equal to the sum of all digits. Got it? And when you
yes,
put
sir.
It in the loop, when you put it in the loop itself, in the if or something, you are not finding sum completely because it's a cumulative sum or iterative sum. And if it is iterative sum, how can you find compare, you know, your original value with sum there? If it is an iterative, correct or not?
Yes.
Do you understand my point?
Yes, sir.
You have to find total sum.
He's asking
you to find
something.
You have to find total sum here, Sandy. Once you find total sum, then you have to go for comparison. Suppose you put this in the loop itself, Sandy. Suppose you put here. Okay, then, you know, by now, if you put it here, for the first time, it will see y is a factor, or second time, it will check y is factor, or third time. You know, this happens, suppose, if z is some 6. It checks for 6 times, in that 6 times, 4 times, it might be, because there are 4 factors for 6. And every time it is a factor, you are doing sum, and this is not complete sum, you get an incremental sum here, or a cumulative sum. And you cannot compare that cumulative sum or incremental to the this if here. You got it right? So let that loop completes finding sum. After that, you put a condition check after loop. So that will be more efficient way of, you know, finding the, you know, checking this. That would be more appropriate, Sandy. Ardhamavutunda? Malli idi string kinda convert chesam. Idi string convert cheyamani evaru chepparu? Why did you convert this to string, this jet? Because you are taking input as string. You might by thinking that finally it has to be string or what?
Yeah, I was thinking like that for the value it has to be a string.
No need. Because as you input as this input function, it by default accepts everything as string. We are converting that to integer. But you know, only if I ask you to convert back to string, then only you need to do it. Otherwise, it's not necessary, Sandy. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Ardhamainda nenu cheppedi?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's how. Okay, you have almost reached there. That's really excellent. That's really good. Still, what I'm seeing is more practice is required. So what you do is, Sandy, if you need my help, I told you, right, after session you can sit with me for some time. Otherwise, what you can do, you can take, you know, ownership and you can practice. That is also fine. And I didn't get the result because instead of number, I have to use what here? Sum minus z equal to. Okay, that's perfect. Come up in the right way. But still, I am not getting that is factor. Let me check. Something is missing here, okay? Okay.
Num plus that to put the 5. Can you do that?
See here, Sandy. One correction with code. Are you looking at this? Just now, eh?
Yes, sir.
It's not even coming to this point. Ikachusava. Incrementation it is inside if. It has to be for while, not for if. You got it?
Oh. Yes, sir, I got it.
See, incrementation should be for loop, not for if. If you push inside, you know, there is no.
Then don't you do the same thing to the sum? Like the sum, like do you do the same thing to the sum plus or equals plus equals y?
This is a different thing, right? You have to do some only when number is a factor, but you should increment the loop iterates, right?
Oh,
you understand okay. what I am explaining?
Yes, sir.
Ardhamavutunda, Sandy?
Yes, sir.
Adi factor aithene sum jaragali. తన లూపల కాదు ప్రతిసారి తిరగాలి అర్థం కాలేదా
If while oh yeah it makes sense
okay loop has to iterate everything and so that loop variable should increment every time but sum has to happen only if a y is a factor got it
yes sir.
Okay and the issue here is with the
indentation
here you are applying plus here don't apply plus in print comma yeah in the print statement you have use comma don't apply concatenation what is that you should use comma
oh
so you got it right
okay yes sir
so that's it these are the all the corrections many corrections what we have so far on this program seems like everybody has solved this okay it's good guys we'll continue tomorrow with more programs so then maybe next one or two sessions then you'll be you don't need to wait anymore you have a lot of logic in your plate and if you have time in the meanwhile you can take a logic and keep solving that and giving the answer you can keep giving me the answers okay so that way your time will be any questions guys Snigdha Shreya
no sir
Pranav any questions
no questions sir
No questions, sir.
Okay, Sandy, how about you? I have a little input for you. Others can leave the session. I would like to talk with Sandy for some time.
Okay. I think I need some practice on some while loops, sir.
Yeah, we'll discuss that. That's why we will have a discussion now. Others, thank you guys. Have a good day.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yep.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for all of you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, Sandy.
Yes, sir.
Sandy, I'm seeing you have some you know you are missing somewhere a few things. You need to keep that on track konni miss avutunnattu kanipistundi Sandy avanni konjam practice cheyali okay na